Now I am going to tell you about the longitudinal or the axial aberration. As the name suggests, that this is due to the number of foci on the principal axis of the lens. Due to dispersion of light by lens. There are number of foci of the lens. The difference between foci for retina and violet color is called axial or longitudinal aberration. Longitudinal aberration. So now I take that the longitudinal aberration duodenal aberration. This is equal to FR minus F. As we know, the lens maker formula this we have 1 upon F equal to mu minus 1 into 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R2. Mu, the refractive index, F, the focal length, R1 and R2, the radii of curvature. So now, as we know that this mu varies with the wavelength of light. The refractive index mu is equal to a plus b upon lambda square plus c upon lambda 4 plus and so on. I have told you earlier to this relation. So this mu varies with the wavelength. So this focal length also varies with the wavelength. And we know that the refractive index is more for violet color and less for the red color. Refractive index mu v is more than mu r, so the focal length FV is less than FR. FV less than FR. So this is the difference. So this FR minus FV, this is the longitudinal average. So now you can have the unit of this one that I will tell you later on. So here we have a lens. This is now principal axis. Here this is now light ray. And this will be dispersed into the two colors that we have taken. This is red and this is violet. This is red and this is now violet. So this is focal length FR. This is now focal length FV. So between this FR minus FV, this so much is called the longitudinal or the axial aberration. So from red, violet to red. Now this so much difference is called the axial aberration. So it is axial aberration. Axial aberration. So now we have this formula. So for violet color, we can have this 1 upon FV is equal to mu V minus 1 into 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R1. And for red color, this we have 1 upon FR equal to mu R minus 1 into 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R. You see that there is no change in the focal length in this dispersal. So now we subtract. This is now suppose relation number 1, this is now relation number 2. So subtract 1 from 2. Subtract. Equation 2 from 1. If you go through this, then you can find a, this is now suppose this 1 upon FV minus 1 upon FR, this is equal to mu V minus mu r into 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r. So now we can have this fr minus fv upon FR into FB. This is equal to mu B minus mu R into 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R. So now you can have to this FR minus LB. This is equal to. This is not suppose your F by E square. F by E square. And this is now your mu B minus mu R into 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R1. Mu by E means that this is for yellow color. Because yellow color is the medium color of this red and the violet. So in the product of these two, we can write this F by E square. So this is equal to F by into omega. So this is equal to FR minus FB. This is not so much. Where this 1 upon FY, this is equal to mu y minus 1 into 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R1. And this omega, this is for yellow color. For yellow color. Yellow color. And now omega is the dispersive power. Omega. This is equal to dispersive power, and this is equal to mu B minus mu R upon mu Y minus 1. So you can see that the product of the medium color and the dispersive power, wavelength for the medium color yellow, and that the dispersive power is equal to the longitudinal average. And now you can see that this has the dimensions of the length. So unit, this is in centimeter, and the dimensional formula . So this is not the unit for this omega, but this is the unit for FR minus LV. So this is equal to M0, L1 and T0. It is for longitudinal. Longitudinal average. So this dimension formula is for longitudinal aberration, and this unit is for longitudinal aberration. So this FR minus FB, now this difference is called the longitudinal aberration. So this is the axial or the longitudinal aberration of the lens. So the unit of this one is centimeter, and it has the dimensional formula M0, L1 and T0. So this is about the the longitudinal or the axial average. So thank you very much.